Economic capital or ECAP is the buffer banks maintain to protect themselves against unexpected losses (UL). ECAP is the complement to the loan loss provisions which protect the bank against expected losses (EL). If you are not familiar with these terms, you can check out our videos on these topics. The loan loss provisions are part of the bank's liabilities. The economic capital is financed through equity. The more economic capital a bank can rally, the more stable the institution is. High capital buffer against unexpected losses will translate into a high credit rating. No capital buffer is high enough to protect the bank against all future risks. There will always be a slice of uncovered risk. If we run a Monte Carlo simulation and simulate 1,000 virtual lives of our bank, we will also generate 1,000 future loan losses. We put these losses in a graph. Now we can split the losses in three parts. The area to the left represents the expected losses. The loan loss provisions cover this risk. The second part is the unexpected losses. Here the economic capital provides protection. In the right-hand tail of the graph we find the uncovered risk. By its nature, there is no protection for this tail risk. Although the economic capital is part of the equity buffer, it is better to think of this ECAP as a performance measurement tool. Equity capital does not come for free. Shareholders demand a solid return on their investment. Equity funding is more expensive than debt. Shareholder return on investment expectations exceed the interest on savings or debt funding. So, economic capital is expensive. Banks deploy this capital with prudence. They will evaluate the performance of business units and projects in the light of capital consumption. Riskier projects, loans, and investments will need more capital. More risk as such is not a problem. The question is whether the return justifies the capital consumption. This brings us to the concept of RAROC. The acronym stands for risk-adjusted return on capital. Banks use RAROC to evaluate their business and lending activities. The RAROC ratio is linked to the concept of economic capital. We see this in the RAROC formula. The gist of RAROC is that we divide the bank's net loan income by the economic capital. In other words, what is the return on each monetary unit invested in economic capital? As was said, the economic capital is a performance measurement tool. It is not a pile of banknotes sitting on the director's desk. We should not think of the capital in physical terms. The bank will deploy this capital in short-term assets such as overnight deposits. This way, ECAP itself also produces a return. The return equals the overnight rate. For example, a reference rate such as LIBOR, Euribor, or the risk-free rate. We can refine our RAROC formula. Let us look at an Excel example. From the income statement we take the net income, the operational expenses and the reservations for expected loan losses. Next, we take the economic capital. Again, if you do not know how to calculate the ECAP, then watch our video on this theme. Furthermore, we need to risk-free rate, which in our case is Euribor, 200 basis points, which equals 2%. Our RAROC equals 22%. Every unit invested in economic capital yields a return of 22 cents. Whether this is good or bad depends on the shareholders' expectations. Say, the bank's shareholders expect an annual return of 15%. In that case, 22% is excellent. One could say that any loan or project with yield that exceeds the shareholders' expectations is good. This brings to an adjacent concept that is often used also in banking, economic value added or EVA. The EVA measures the value the bank generates from the funds invested and the risk taken on. In other words, is the bank generating shareholder value taking into consideration the expectations and risk appetite of the shareholders? We assumed that the shareholders expect a return of 15%. With RAROC equal to 22% and 100,000 in economic capital, we can fill in the formula. The EVA equals 7,000. This is the value the bank created for its shareholders. Thanks for watching.